In this video, we're going to cover all things delay. There's some new options for using delay lines when working in rnbo, in addition to some familiar workflows. We'll look at a couple of audio delay patches that demonstrate the different methods you can use. rnbo doesn't use tap-in and tap-out objects to create delay lines, which is a common method in MSP. We'll show you several methods you can use to work with delay lines in rnbo. The simplest way to work with an audio delay line in rnbo is by using the delay object. Time can be set either as a fixed duration in milliseconds using the @maxDelayMS attribute, or as a specific number of samples using @maxDelay. When using @maxDelay, you can set the maximum delay memory using the vector size or the sample rate of the target platform. This can be useful to ensure that the delay memory remains a function of time. For example, setting @maxSize sample rate times 2 ensures that you have a 2-second buffer on all target platforms. If you would like to create a ping pong delay, you can try the new pan tilde object and connect it in the following way. Feedback connections in the rnbo patching environment are handled using the feedback tilde object. In gen, the history operator allows feedback in the gen patcher through insertion of a single sample delay. Feedback operates the same way, except it works by introducing a single vector buffer of delay. You can use the new vector size tilde object to output the current vector size. Unlike MSP, send and receive tilde in rnbo do not introduce one sample of delay when patched in a feedback loop and cannot be patched directly. If you've used this strategy in the past, simply add a feedback tilde object in series and you'll now see rnbo compile. You can see that rnbo tilde won't allow you to create feedback connections in your audio signal flow without the feedback object, so it's easy to remember. If you would like your feedback delay connections to work on a per sample basis, use a gen patcher inside of rnbo. Here is a simple implementation of a gen delay using the history and delay operators, which can be expanded to a multi-tap version using the taps argument. The delay tilde object in rnbo is great for making delay lines, but if you would like more control over your DSP, like interpolation, we can create our own circular buffer using splat tilde, wave tilde, and data to create 64-bit delay lines. We use splat tilde to overdub our signal input into data, which we can read back using wave tilde. If you'd like more taps to create a multi-tap delay, just create an additional wave tilde object referencing the same data object. This is essentially what the tap-in tilde and tap-out tilde objects are doing under the hood when you add taps in the tap-out object. Try experimenting with the following interpolation modes for wave tilde: linear, cubic, spline, cosine, step, and none. We can also introduce an all-pass tilde object into our feedback chain to alter the character of the sound. You can even use all-pass tilde by itself to create a delay effect with a flat magnitude response and potentially complex phase response that's interesting for transients. When creating delay lines for external targets, it's important to keep the memory of the hardware in mind. Although it's doubtful you'll exceed a Raspberry Pi's memory, even at 1 GB. The granulator tilde object is fun to include in your audio delay line patches. The granular delay example in rnbo demonstrates some of the above methods and how to integrate the granulator tilde object. Let's take the basic rnbo ringbuffer delay patch and turn it into a multi-tap delay using polyphony. We can add the @polyphony8 attribute to clone our delay patch as a novel approach to creating a multi-tap delay from the same audio input. We'll use a MIDI keyboard to trigger new taps each time a new MIDI note is played. By adding the @exposedvoiceparams attribute, we can offset the delay times for each of the individual voices. This patcher will work in the browser and other external targets. Happy patching!